That's a good question. You know, when the legal education system was organized in 1961 under the Advocates Act, our main concern of training lawyers was for litigation. And the Bar Council scheme of legal education was designed for that purpose. I recall that initially under the Advocates Act, one would be doing a three-year LLB program after the BA, BSc, BCom, the first degree. And then after getting the LLB degree, one has to go for an apprenticeship of almost an year's duration with a senior lawyer and learn the skills of the basic skills for advocacy. Then you have to take a bar counsel examination, and then only you are enrolled as an advocate. That was the system prevailing for the first nearly 20 years after the Advocates Act. But then we discovered that in a republic of India's size and complexity, one has to have some basic skills training within the law school itself, instead of completing the degree and then going for an apprenticeship. How does one organize it? Secondly, to be able to sort out the diverse problems of our developing society, one has to have an interdisciplinary understanding of law. How does law function in society? So law in social context education was felt necessary. The Bar Council had series of consultations, and ultimately the five-year integrated program was developed. And a substantial portion of the five-year integrated program was devoted to interdisciplinary learning, understanding law in social context, as well as the learning of the skills. Skills such as legal research, legal writing, communication skills, fact-gathering skills, fact appreciation or assessment, etc. A whole lot of skills that go to make a legal practitioner. Well, this was done differently by different law schools. There was no particular model. The National Law School at Bangalore, which was established in 1986-87, was the only model that was experimenting and trying to innovate as to how interdisciplinarity as well as clinical education can be combined to make legal education more comprehensive and competent. I believe that it did serve a great purpose. It was a revolutionary change at that point of time. The five-year scheme could attract very talented students passing out of the 12th standard of school examination, and they were amenable to different models of legal learning. The teachers also were learning with them, and the success of the National Law School at Bangalore has persuaded many states to set up a law university in their respective states. I believe today, because around that time in 1990s, we had the economic liberalization, privatization and globalization. We had a lot of private investment in our country, and the economic rate of growth was growing, challenging the legal system in many ways. It was under those circumstances the five-year course was developed, and the legal market has demanded a whole lot of lawyers who are not necessarily dispute resolution agents litigating in courts, but doing a variety of legal transactions which facilitated the market-oriented economy and the development processes. So therefore, it did serve a purpose at a crucial time in the evolution of our economy. The legal system got transformed into some areas of diversification with specialization in different sectors of the economy and the social sector. So the Constitution demanded justice, social, economic, and political. So we wanted social engineers who would use the legal instruments and legal institutions and processes to advance the goal of social justice, to advance the goal of economic justice, to advance the goal of political justice. So therefore, I think that the 1990s, what the five-year integrated course graduates have played, have been a significant role in the evolution of Indian legal mechanisms. But today the situation is different. A large amount of technological infusion into society, particularly the IT, have revolutionized the communication and the methods at a cost-effective manner. You can gather facts, analyze facts and law. That has changed the context in which law has to be studied today. Therefore, I believe that if the five-year integrated course in 1980s have attempted to bring law in the context of society, today, not only in the context of society, but in the context of science and technology, has become very important. Now, how does one look at the problems that are thrown up in our financial sector, for example, by reason of the developments in IT? You know, what is cyber crime? What is cyber law? It's just one example of how revolutionary challenges have been brought to the legal system from the sector of technology. Now, similarly in biotechnology, similarly in technology related to the manufacturing sector or the services sector, you find various challenges. How does the future lawyer will look at problems thrown up, the type that we had on 2G spectrum, or the type that we may have with respect to space technology? Well, this is a big challenge. That is why I think the five-year integrated course, if you have to reframe that in 2018 or 2020 and beyond, you have to see as to how a future lawyer and a judge or a legal practitioner can be comfortable with these multiple technologies, which are the driving forces for social change. And that is to be brought into the curriculum. How do you organize it? Give you an example of the forensic sciences, and they are a dozen different scientific disciplines integrated into an appraisal of legal and social facts. This is an important thing. You need different social institutions like that we have the commercial courts now. We have the Green Tribunal now. You may have specialized bodies like the Securities and Exchange Board, the Competition Commission of India, you know, which has regulatory jurisprudence of its own, which is a blending of technology along with legal principles and social justice goals. How does the law teacher capture this thing and convey it to the future law graduate is indeed a challenge. So if you are the question that you asked as to how a five-year course can be reorganized to face future challenges, this is the challenge. I don't have any ready answers, but it requires innovation and experimentation.